Without the ball, Tom, he is constantly striving to get open.
A lot of young kids watching should watch him move around, because he plays a game without the ball. As Dan says, you stand around, you're just not going to be doing much.
You hurt the team.
Nally, Miley, Winona Cotter along the banks of the Mississippi in southeastern Minnesota, beautiful part of our great state. And that shot is up and good. It is Glowacki.
Fun to watch this man-to-man defense and the man-to-man offense by both clubs. They're both very well coached. Good ball movement, good movement without the ball.
De La Salle leading by a point, a minute 25 remaining first quarter. Pull-up jumper, no good by Dragotis. The follow-up shot is no good by Carson. Next rebound, McLaughlin. Carson, he gets it.
Persistence pays off.
There you see the score. De La Salle up by three. Cotter with the ball. Matt Malley, a minute left, first quarter. At the free throw line is Galkowski. Don't leave him alone. He'll pop it in on you. He had 19 yesterday, four in his first game here in the state tournament, and their 50-46 win. Or I should say they went over Le Sueur at four. Ball will go the other way. De La Salle defeated Twin Valley 50-46. And then Ceylon 62-51 to get into this championship game. Cotter won 39-27 over Le Sueur. And then one big over Greenway Coleraine yesterday to make it into this title game.
17 seconds on the clock, Tom.
Miley. Loose ball pulled out of there. Shot was missed by Glowacki. De La Salle with the ball. Dragotis with that last second shot. Hang those numbers up on the board. The young man wanted it. And that's the end of the first quarter with a score of Minneapolis De La Salle 14, Winona Cotter 11.
I'm Lorne Green. Next on New Wilderness, we hunt down the truth about the fox. Not the sly villain of the storybooks, but loving mother and selfless defender of her helpless young. Struggling to survive in a world where nothing lives happily ever after.
Calcium and protein too, helps us feel good in whatever we do.
Kick!
So get on a health kick, let it pour.
America's favorite health kick.
Get on a health kick, milk's got more.
Have more milk, cause milk's got more.
There's Mike O'Brien.
Tom, a real tough thing to adjust to as a coach and players in the state tournament is that the state high school league and the television station asks you to stay in the huddle for the full minute and does not want you to wander out. And we are all in such habits of letting the kids go after we're done talking.
Second quarter is underway. De La Salle with the lead and the ball. Into the front court is Brad Baker. Nathan Carson with it now. That's Wynn. Wynn being guarded by Hailey. Almost stolen away, and traveling is called. Good defensive play by Jeff Glowacki, who forced the traveling violation.
Entrance pass, the man cutting the baseline. Got it caught on his hip.
De La Salle 7 out of 14 from the field. Cotter 3 out of 10. There's a close-in jump shot, and it's canned by Matt Malley. 14-13, De La Salle, that one-point lead. Second quarter, 7-12 remaining. The championship, state of Minnesota, Class A. De La Salle with 353 students, Winona Cotter with 183. Lynn almost lost it. Seeing a rarity, both teams playing a man-to-man. Damon the Dragon Dragotis.
You never know, Tom, that might stick.
He's a player. That's a great name in itself.
Did you call that a sport name, Ray?
Oh, yes.
Eileen. That was a cross between a set shot and a jump shot.
That is a good explanation.
Gregotis works it into McLaughlin, who goes up and pans it. He's a worker.
6'6 senior.
16-13 De La Salle with 6 minutes left to go in the half. Two well-coached teams here. It's the first time ever a state championship game has been coached by two rookie coaches. Dragotis tried to shovel it in. He has that ability to go into the air and stay there.
Put a little extra English on the ball, which wasn't needed. He should have just laid it off the glass.
That hurts him. Sometimes he puts a little bit too much spin. He missed quite a few close-in shots yesterday with Eric. Pulled out of there by Carson. De La Salle with the ball. Baker. Mike Wynn. In and out by Nathan Carson. The rebound by Carson. Scramble. Cotter clears it out of there.
Carson is an aggressive basketball player.
Cotter down by three with the ball. And there is a foul on Nathan Carson. We were talking about his aggressiveness.
Sometimes maybe overly aggressive. We'll see if he's overly aggressive or not. as a player, he might have a complaint.
To the line, that's number 51, Joel Bergeson. Not a big scorer in this tournament. He did not score in the first game. He's had four yesterday. He averages about 10 a game. 6'5 senior. De La Salle comes out of there. They have a three-point lead. Lob pass to Wynn. Good body control. Walking will be called. Timeout on the floor with the score. Minneapolis De La Salle 16. Winona Cotter 13.
How's business, Fred?
Oh, great, Al. Especially since I lowered the price of Eradicane.
Blow, lasso, and dual?
Yep. Always sold Eradicane for the toughest weeds in corn, but you can't beat it for annual grasses. Now that I lowered the price, even you guys should mix it with Bladex for grasses and broadleaves.
You lowered the price?
Always take care of you guys.
In that case, Fred, you're buying.
Next.
Eradicane 6.70 and Bladex. Great annual grass control at a new low, low price.
This week in country music, we'll preview a new TV special and see why a full house of country superstars adds up to a winning hand.
Alabama pays tribute to the working man and woman in the new video, 40 Hour Week.
Jeannie C. Riley shares her real-life love story with us.
Plus, we'll meet rising star Keith Stegall and hear his new single. Hi, I'm Charlie Chase.
I'm Lori Ann Crook. Don't miss it this week in country music.
Do you want it?
Yeah!
They're gonna come at you hard?
Yes!
All right, 1, 2, 3.
Defense!
Let's go, guys. Hey, no fouls, no fouls. Let me see everybody down low. No, not now, not now. Man, man.
He just gave a piece of information to his players, which is the most important defensive information he could give. I want you down low.
It's hard to play a man-to-man standing upright. You're going to get faked out every time.
Many people try it.
There's one advantage to playing a man-to-man straight up. You can see the guy go by a lot easier. That shot's up and good. I think it's Drussel who just checked in. Mark Drussel, number 53. 1 point ball game.
Double dribble on McLaughlin time.
De La Salle with a point lead, and Cotter has a chance to grab it back. There's Cotter coach Mike O'Brien, who replaced the great John Nett, the winningest coach in Minnesota history. 582 victories. Well, that'll be a play that'll be discussed.
Mike O'Brien had that "surely you jest" look on his face.
And more, I think, that time, Ray. Surely you're crazy.
Here it is.
Oh, yeah.
Got both of them going too quick, didn't he?
Cotter with the ball. Chance to grab a lead. 3:49 remaining in the half. De La Salle up by a point. Two well-disciplined precision ball clubs down there. That's a fine-looking play by guess who? Jeff Blawacki.
Well, Jeff happens to be leading scorer on the team. Did you notice the excellent positioning he had? He had his man pinned. Gave him a fake to the left, rolled into the lane and made it.
Third foul for Carson. Three-point play, Glowacki. He now has 10. And Cotter with a two-point lead, 18-16. 3.5 minutes left in the half. Dragotis. Hang up the numbers.
Nothing but bottom of net.
He averages 18 a game. In this tournament, he's at 19 and 23 points. He has 6 so far in the first half. Baseline shut off. And here's a foul is called. Is it on Wynn? I think it is.
It was on Wynn, Tom. He reached. Tried to slap the ball, but missed and hit the man's forearm.
Boy, Bill Brown has to be smiling wherever he is watching this tournament. He's got to be thinking that his hairstyle is finally coming back. Looking at De La Salle. Former Viking we're talking about, Billy Brown, who wears the same haircut as way back in his days at Mendota, Illinois, when he was in high school. Dragotis.
Forced that one a little bit.
We're tied at 18. 2:45 left to go in the half. Alley, Eilee, stays in the air, nice. Wynn comes off with it. De La Salle with a chance to grab the lead. Nice pass by Dragotis. He just flicked it with that right arm and it was a shot right on the numbers.
He makes it look easy.
Wynn. That's Moser. Rebound is yanked out of there by Mark Drussel. Of Winona Cotter. We're tied. 2 minutes left in the half. 2 minutes. Eilee looks for Glowacki. And here's a foul on De La Salle on McLaughlin.
Help side defense is there. McLaughlin is the help side defense, and the foul is credited to him. What I mean by help side defense is there's a man guarding, a defensive man guarding the ball, guarding the man that the man with the ball is trying to get to, and the man who is playing guarding a forward on the other side comes into the lane to help out his defensive partner.
right. We have a one-point lead for Cotter, 19-18. A minute 50 left to go in the half. Win, De La Salle. Off the fingertips and out of bounds. And a timeout on the floor with the score. Cotter 19, De La Salle 18.
Pour on the power, go for the glory. This is the story of what you're made of.
Be, give strength, it helps you do it. Be, give strength. Through it.
Beef in a balanced diet. It's one of the best sources of protein, iron, and B vitamins going for a whole new pride in strength.
Beef gives strength. I'll keep you going. Beef gives strength from inside. Beef puts pride in a body. Beef gives strength.
Some people worry needlessly about their IRAs. But you can relax, sir. Your IRA is at Home Federal Savings Bank, where you pay no fees, where you receive high interest, and where your money grows from the moment of deposit, and you get that marvelous tax deduction. What's the matter, sir? You know your IRA is at Home Federal.
But will the Vikings win in 85?
Oh, I don't know.
Man, board.
Coach has always got to get that last word in there as they break the huddle.
I believe you said board, didn't he?
Yep.
That means hit the rebound.
According to my records here, Tom, Cotter has committed only one foul so far.
And they're playing man-to-man, Ray. Aggressively.
Very unusual.
They had one foul in the first half yesterday, so this is a team that will not go out and beat itself. A minute 22 remaining in the half.
Well, that had to be close to 5 seconds now.
Leading 19-18. Lead pass. Only Malley didn't get there, and De La Salle has it. Malley was cut off by the defense. Baker. That's Wynn. He had a shot there, but pass it up to Godis. An air ball. Rarely do you see that.
Trice!
Defensive man did an excellent job on Nagotis. He did not try and block the shot. He just went up and screened him. He was up a little bit higher than Nagotis, and Nagotis had to change his arc.
That's Glowacki. Good defensive play by McLaughlin.
The referees are letting these kids play today, and I like that. They're not calling every little chippy hand in or push. They're letting them play.
Second, that was Moser who made the good defensive play.
Watching going through.
Bragotis.
Did you see how they cleared out a side for him? They gave Bragotis the whole right side to operate.
De La Salle. That's Baker. 6 seconds. Wynn. Didn't get it. I don't think that one would have counted. The horn had sounded. So, this game is everything we thought that it would be. Been back and forth, momentum changing about every couple of minutes or so. And the guys in yellow, the state's number one ranked Class A team, with a lead. Let's go down to the floor now.
All right, thanks very much, Tom. Don, back and forth ball game, exactly what you expected?
Yes, exactly. Two very good, disciplined, defensive playing teams. That's what shows on the scoreboard right now.
You're not able to get your running game going. Did you want to try to do that in the first half?
And we want to run, but you've got to get the defensive boards to do so. And even when we do get the boards, Cotter's an excellent ball club, and they get back very well. So we're going to have to bide our time to work that break.
All right, you're going in to talk to your kids. What do you tell them?
Keep playing tough defense. We got in foul trouble early. We got to avoid the fouls and stop putting them at the free throw line. How about if we keep our defense and just take a little more time on offense? We'll be all right.
All right, we'll see you in the second half.
Thank you.
Thanks, Don. Let's go back upstairs.
Okay, you mentioned fouls, and Winona Cotter, they're not having any foul trouble, so we'll keep that in mind. That's the end of the first half. With the score, Minneapolis De La Salle 20 and Winona Cotter 19.
Milk! Milk's got the kick that gives you more.
Health kick!
More nutrition in every pore.
Health kick! The calcium in milk helps me stay in shape. I'm looking good, baby, feeling great.
So get on a health kick, let it pour. America's favorite health kick. Get on a health kick, milk's got more. Have more milk, cause milk's got more.
The greatest talent hunt in America continues on Star Search 85. Ed McMahon is joined by Hoyt Axton and Gloria Loring as the competition heats up. There's $1.5 million at stake in the year's hottest race for the stars. Someone's got a voice of gold. Someone's got that golden look. Someone will take home all the gold in the race for stardom. It's television at its very best. This week on Star Search 85.
Sunday night at 10:30 on KTTC.
All right, we are at halftime here, this Class A championship game between Winona Cotter, the Ramblers, and Minneapolis De La Salle, the Islanders, both teams in the locker rooms. There you see the Bloomington Jefferson Flag and Drum Corps, and tonight Jefferson will be playing for third place in Double A against Duluth Central. Jefferson played with great pride last night and hustle, but came up short, losing to the number one ranked team, White Bear Lake, by a score of 41-39. That was, to date, the best game of the tournament. This one certainly is vying for that particular title. It's halftime. Let's enjoy the entertainment.
Thank you.
right, we're at halftime, and Minneapolis De La Salle with a one-point lead over Winona Cotter for the A Division Championship, State of Minnesota. This is the 1985 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament.
The whole truth.
Just answer yes or no.
Justice for all.
It's just not fair for the public to get ripped off.
An education.
This is one way to learn, by coming to court.
Law and order.
He stole my car.
Integrity.
You have very little credibility with this court.
Equality.
Can I say something, sir?
And humanity.
I feel for both of the parties in this case.
Your principles still count on the People's Court.
Monday through Friday, 5 p.m. on KTTC.
The Byron Sportsman and Conservation Club is sponsoring the third annual Fishing Fever Seminar, April 3rd at 7:30 p.m. at Byron High School. Babe Winkleman, well-known TV fishing personality, outdoor writer, and fishing educator, returns to Byron to conduct one of his famous fishing seminars. Meet Babe Winkleman Wednesday, April 3rd at 7:30 p.m. at Byron High School. Tickets are $5 at the door for the third annual Fishing Fever Seminar. Don't miss it.
All right, we're back at the St. Paul Civic Center. Let's get down to the floor.
All right, thanks a lot, Tom. You know, we talk a lot about where some of these players are going to end up, play some college basketball after they get out of the high school tournament. This fella here knows his name, Butch Raymond, the coach at St. Cloud State University. Let's talk Division II basketball, because that's where a lot of these kids do end up.
Well, especially, I think, in our league, Jeff, the North Central Conference. It's such a great Division II league. In fact, our conference champion, South Dakota State, is playing for the national title tonight in Springfield, Massachusetts. But we've got players in our league like Tommy McDonald from Chisholm. On our own ball club, we've got Terry Keekley, a freshman that started for us from Armstrong. We've got Todd Spaulding from Kimball. Joe Geiger played a lot for us this year. And I guess probably in our own injury, we got Barry Woller coming back. He's going to play at St. Cloud next year, transferred back. Mike Hillman transferred back from Aiken, Minnesota. Kevin Traynor came back from Coon Rapids. So our ball club is basically all Minnesota people, along with a couple from the outsides. This is the league we feel that is the top league, and we like those players in our league.
A lot of your competition, as you were saying, Minnesota kids, a lot of them that have played out here, in names that we could remember.
Well, Tommy McDonald is playing. John Anderson played in our league. Mark Harrison is playing in our league at North Dakota State. And it's just excellent basketball, and we like the Minnesota player. I think all the coaches in our league do, but we like David Gilreath, led our league in scoring from Marshall U High. Jerry Williams was his counterpart at Mankato State. So it's basically a Minnesota league, but it's an excellent league.
What about the kids you're seeing now in the tournaments? A lot of recruiting pressure on some of these kids. Are you really interested in some of them?
Oh, there's no question about that. When you look at the final game tonight with White Bear Lake and the Ogdens and the Rainiers, then you look at Minneapolis North and the players that they have, there's some good talent there, and some very heavily recruiting players are looking for our league, I think.
Well, I think for a lot of these players, Division II basketball is where it's at. And because of you, it makes it so successful. Thanks a lot for stopping by.
Thanks, Jeff.
Let's go back upstairs.
All right, Jeff Passel, a former St. Cloud State hockey star, I might add, visiting with the basketball coach at St. Cloud State. Couldn't you just die when everybody wants to party after the game and you just want to go home? Well, why don't you? 1985 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament will continue after station identification.
The Minnesota State Boys High School Basketball Tournament will be concluding tonight with a 9 o'clock game here on KTTC. Tune in for the Class AA Championship game between defending champion White Bear Lake and Minneapolis North.
I get angry just thinking about it makes me mad. Little kids doing drugs, it turns my stomach. That stuff hurts. Stop you from living up to your potential. It holds you back. It hurts the user. It hurts his family. And it hurts his friends. I just want to shake some sense into you kids that are using drugs and think about using. So remember, don't, or else. Okay?
I'm Lorne Green. Next on New Wilderness, we hunt down the truth about the fox. Not the sly villain of the storybooks, but loving mother and selfless defender of her helpless young. Struggling to survive in a world where nothing lives happily ever after.
KTTC, Television 10,
Rochester.
It may be kind of dreary and overcast outside, but we have a good red-hot ball game in here for the A championship. This is the 1985 Minnesota State High School Boys Basketball Tournament.
You've heard it said time and time again. The mail must go through. And against all odds, it usually does. The mail does go through. It's just that in your northwestern bell zone...
Can't you see I'm on the phone?
Long distance goes through first. If you have something important to say, say it with Northwestern Bell.
This week in country music, we'll preview a new TV special and see why a full house of country superstars adds up to a winning hand.
Alabama pays tribute to the working man and woman in the new video, 40-Hour Week.
Jeannie C. Riley shares her real-life love story with us.
Plus, we'll meet rising star Keith Stegall and hear his new single. Hi, I'm Charlie Chase.
I'm Laurie Ann Crook. Don't miss it this week in country music.
All right, there you see a state tournament fan just got back from Honolulu.
I wish I was there.
You gotta play tough. Offensively, let's go for three or more passes. Unless you can get the man trading layup. Let's go. Come on, guys. Come on, come on. Our lady victory, quick. You guys want it?
Yeah!
You know they're gonna come at you?
Yeah.
One, two, three, four.
With a tip.
Nate, on the baseline, right?
Yeah, I'm on the defense, right.
Boy, you just can't beat high school athletics. Just can't beat it. I love it. Congratulations to all the high schools in the state of Minnesota, the State High School League, all these great tournaments. We salute not only the champions, but all the participants. Here we go, second half. Class A championship game. The tip, controlled by really almost a flawless basketball team out there. Fundamentally sound, Winona Cotter.
I think you can ditto it for De La Salle.
Really? Two fine ball clubs, I tell you. Just...
Come on, don't force it, my girl. Don't force it, reverse it.
Just think of the hours and hours of practice to get these teams where they are today, at the top.
Some people think the coach just rolls out the ball and the kids play.
Driving down, that shot was no good. De La Salle with a one-point lead now, and the ball. Good faking by Wynn off the back rim. Pulled out of there by Hiley. Doubles it over to Malley.
Kind of like they're in the first round again, Tom.
There's one of the few mistakes that you'll see either of these teams make. There goes Damon Dragotis. Oh, if he had made that shot, this place would have erupted. With one hand, he handled that ball. I can't even describe what he did.
We can describe that one, though.
Yep.
Move both feet at once.
See this again.
Excellent heads-up play to get the ball to Gregotis. A spinning pass. He drives the lane. Just a little hard off the glass.
Malley. De La Salle still with that 20-19 lead. 20-19. 6.5 left. Third quarter. Hiley. Down the lane. Ball rolls around. Bergeson scores to Winona Cotter, and they have a one-point lead.
Both man-to-man aggressive defenses.
Brad Baker with it. Brad doesn't score much. His contributions add up to more than points. Now he must have heard me.
He did.
And De La Salle with a one-point lead.
A little pressure by De La Salle, Tom. Double-teaming the ball.
5:50 remaining third quarter. Hiley got his own rebound. Ai Lee in there with the Giants. He's only 5'10", and here's a foul on Ai Lee.
And who took the shot, Tom? Ai Lee. Who was frustrated because he missed? Ai Lee. Who committed the foul? Ai Lee. There he is. He's mad at himself.
Baker. That's the voice of Don Zierden, the De La Salle coach. Both the coaches with the wireless microphones on. Dragotis off balance on that shot. De La Salle with a 22-21 lead, and Cotter with the ball. Third quarter. Cotter, their two losses coming to two Wisconsin schools, both very close games. They lost to Logan of La Crosse and Prairie du Chien.
What a defensive play by Brad Baker, stripping the big guy of the ball in the lob. Excellent.
Look at it again.
Entrance pass, the lob. Baker comes in and strips it. Excellent job.
And in live action, scoring for Winona Cotter's number 23, Glowacki. And they lead 23-22. Win. Got it. Good position. And De La Salle has a one-point lead. It's just back and forth.
This is a basketball game. That's what it's all about.
That's it.
The ebb and flow.
And the dream matchup tonight in Double A, White Bear Lake and Minneapolis North. Both of them unbeaten. Timeout on the floor. With the score, De La Salle 24 and Winona Cotter 23.
Pour on the power, go for the glory. This is the story of what you're made of.
Beef gives strength, it helps you do it. Beef gives strength, it helps you through it.
Beef in a balanced diet, it's one of the best sources of protein, iron, and B vitamins going for a whole new pride in strength.
Beef gives strength, helps keep you going. Beef gives strength from inside. Beef puts pride in a body. Beef gives strength.
Milk! Milk's got the kick that gives you more.
Health kick!
More nutrition in every pore.
Health kick!
Getting back in shape and milk fits right in. With more calcium and vitamins.
Kick!
So get on a health kick, let it pour. America's favorite health kick. Get on a health kick, milk's got more. Have more milk, cause milk's got more.
Tom, there is a man who is an institution in the inner city basketball, Kwame McDonald. He has taken more pictures and brought joy to more basketball players in the St. Paul Central and Minneapolis North than any man in the Twin City area. Right now, though, he's holding down the backboard.
Everywhere you go, you see Kwame. He is a basketball game would not be without him. He is all over.
He's always wearing the traditional dashiki.
Cotter with a basketball. De La Salle with a one-point lead. The lead just keeps going back and forth, back and forth. Two disciplined teams. Ai Lee into Glowacki. Back rim. Damon Dragotis into the front court for De La Salle. Baker. There's a pull-up jump shot and a dandy by Nathan Carson. 6'5". And a bulging three-point lead now. In this game, that's a lot. Baker. Great pass. Dragotis shovels it off the board and in.
What a pass by Baker, though, to set that play up.
Biggest lead of the game, 5 points for De La Salle. Stolen. Dragotis. He has 12. Suddenly, De La Salle has exploded. And here is a foul on Damon the Dragon.
The double team and the man on the ball, Dragotis gets it off of a tip from his teammate. Finger rolls it in. I would have, as a coach, I'd rather see him put that over the top of the rim, not underneath.
There's a drive, and Potter comes right back. It is number 51, Ferguson. 30-25. De La Salle with a 5-point lead. 3 minutes left to go, third quarter. Class A championship game. Two thoroughbred teams out there playing a great game. Great competition. Carson for De La Salle.
That was set up by a penetrating move and a dish off by Baker. He's quick.
There you see the score. 7-point lead, Minneapolis. De La Salle driving, hook shot, no good. Galkowski had pulled out of there by De La Salle.
These kids are playing.
Dragotis, stop and go, dribble, and now you see him, and now you don't. The Dragon strikes again.
Dragotis is like a fencer. He kind of feints in, feints back, and then attacks.
34-25, De La Salle. In the last couple of minutes, they have suddenly grabbed momentum to build a 9-point lead over an outstanding Winona Cotter Ramblers squad.
Coach Dearden is now putting in his...
Why not begin in November? Download, hit me on the back, and help out. Can you do it?
Yeah.
So listen, they've got two offenses they're going to go to, all right? They're either go to that
four now, so you know you've got to get some buckets off the press all the way down. Your people at half court, you've got to break down. When the ball is broken in the middle, dribbling down court, get down to the basket. Penetrate to the free throw line, all right? You got nothing, then kick it out. Multiple choice. Multiple choice. All right? Let's go now. Win a victory. Let's go.
Never before have two rookie coaches battled for a state championship in Minnesota, and you're in on history today.
Too bad one has to lose. See a 2-2-1 zone press now, Tom.
Perhaps De La Salle beginning to feel the momentum going their way, and they want to make sure it keeps going that way. Glowacki has other ideas. The basket counts, and he's fouled.
High leap, penetrating pass to Glowacki. All he did was muscle the ball up and got fouled from behind.
Second foul on McLaughlin.
You know what the defense, let's go.
34-27, De La Salle, in and out. Rebound, Cotter, and a foul. That battling for that ball again was Glowacki. And he was fouled.
Mark! Mark! Mark!
Moser got him.
You see the aggressive play by Glowacki. And he did what coaches want to see the kid do. He muscled it up and let go of it. Who knows, it might go in.
The foul was on McLaughlin. His third, two quick ones on him. Well, that took the long trip to get in, but it made it. And at the line. Is Dressel. Dressel is 53, Glowacki is 23. And suddenly, another foul.
Nathan Carson.
Yep. Fourth on him. Fourth team foul.
How did he get that? How did he get that?
My question is, how did you...
Little discussion there. And the shot is up and good. Glowacki. Who else? 17 for him. And the lead is cut to four. Cotter is back in it just like that. Aaron shot. Glowacki has it.
Glowacki is so aggressive. And it's paying off for him.
34-30. De La Salle with a 4-point lead. It was 9 moments ago. All alone. Galkowski. Rebound pulled out of there by De La Salle.
Run it!
Baker.
Three passes, Greg. Run the offense, Greg.
Coach Zierden is asking for three passes before they shoot. Let's see what happens. That was one, there's two, there's three. Now they can shoot.
Inside to Damon. Dragotis tried to pass through a crowd there. It was knocked out on top. We're under a minute left to go, third quarter. De La Salle leading 34-30.
Get it out!
Baker. That's Moser to Dragotis.
Move!
He could have used a screen there. It wasn't to be found.
Move, D-Pick!
And there is a pass thrown out of bounds by Greg Moser.
He expected the man to break to his left. He broke to his right. That happened.
And ask Georgetown about that. Remember that game a couple years ago? Cost him the national championship. And here is a jump ball. A good defensive play on Baker. On behalf of Baker, I should say. There he is.
You have both players come in contact with the ball. That's a questionable call by the referees. At least I have always questioned it as a coach. I didn't see both players in total contact.
The tip was controlled by Galkowski, but De La Salle got it. And driving, no basket, no basket. 10 seconds left, third quarter. Let's check that one out.
Do we have the instant replay on that one?
Is it on Malley?
Here's Dragotis driving to his left. Okay, the referee ruled he got him about by the free throw line.
Foul on Malley is his second. Pull up jumper, and it is Damon Dragotis.
Who else?
And that's the end of the third quarter with a score. Minneapolis De La Salle 36. Winona Cotter 30.
You've heard it said time and time again. The mail must go through. And against all odds, it usually does. The mail does go through. It's just that in your northwestern bell zone...
Can't you see I'm on the phone?
Long distance goes through first. If you have something important to say, say it with Northwestern Bell.
The most extensive testing program ever conducted on first-year corn has just been completed by the makers of Counter. And results prove there's a complex of pests, including wireworms, white grubs, and nematodes, that can reduce plant vigor and yields. Controlling these pests with Counter produced an average yield increase of almost 6 bushels per acre. Proof that it pays to treat your first-year corn with Counter.
Of the floor and Jeff Passolt.
Tom, one of the many interesting sidebars involving this state tournament. Hi Lee, the oldest player in the tournament at age 20. He came here in 1975 with his father, who was a South Vietnamese captain after the fall of Saigon. He was immediately held back 2 years to give him a chance to catch up with everybody else in school. Now, he started this season at age 19, but then turned 20 during the season. Because of that, he won't be eligible to play tennis this spring. You can't start a season at age 20 in the Minnesota State High School sports. At any rate, he must be a pretty good student. He's headed for Winona State on a mathematics major. At least that's what he's hoping to do.
All right, good background information there, and it's off the fingertips of Tom McLaughlin of De La Salle. And we've opened the fourth quarter, De La Salle leading Winona Cotter 36-30. Ray Scott has just informed me. Ray, that's incredible. De La Salle has not shot a free throw.
That's right.
Baker, let's up. Boy, that's a nice play on behalf of Brad Baker. 8-point lead, De La Salle. Shot is short, pulling up with it was
get set.
Galkowski. Here's walking going to be called. Taking a little jump with it, a little skip was Bergeson.
The pressure defense is obviously bothering Cotter. I don't know how much man-to-man and zone or man-to-man presses they get down their conference, but nor with the quickness of De La Salle.
Wynn on a good feed inside from Moser, and he pops it in a 10-point De La Salle lead now. Good pass over to High Lee. The pass coming from Malley. First two for High Lee. It's 40-32. De La Salle. Cotter is not fouling, but De La Salle is leading by eight. And they are not helping themselves, obviously, from the free throw line because they can't go to the free throw line. The other team doesn't foul them. So you're looking at 20 field goals for De La Salle. The sum total of their scoring. Win. Pulled out of there by High Lee, and here is a foul on Win.
Who took the shot?
Frustration.
Frustration. Another example, Win misses the a shot, in fact, very poorly, and is very frustrated and angry with himself, and he goes in to get the rebound, overly aggressive, and makes the foul. It's tough to teach a kid to do that.
I don't think a lot of people realize how sophisticated coaching has become. You guys are a constant student of the game. You're going to clinics, you're reading, you're talking to people, hanging around announcers.
That's where I pick up most of my knowledge.
I mean, you can learn just so much there. It's just hard to believe. High Lee.
Got to be impressed with a kid who comes from another country, doesn't know anything about this game, picks it up in a number of years and plays.
Shot good, Galkowacki. And they're back into the game. They're down by five. 6:09 left in regulation time. 40-35, Minneapolis, De La Salle. Quick pass hooked inside by Dragotis. Knocked out of bounds, intended for McLaughlin.
Timeout, here we go.
Timeout on the floor with the score. De La Salle 40 and Winona Cotter 35.
The power, go for the glory. This is the story of what you're made of.
Beef, give strength, it helps you do it. Beef, give strength, it helps you through it.
Beef in a balanced diet, it's one of the best sources of protein, iron, and B vitamins going for a whole new pride in strength.
Beef, give strength, helps keep you going. Beef, give strength from inside. Beef puts pride in a body.
This is the sale everyone's talking about. Valley Furniture is going out of business. Buys, deals, whatever, on beautiful brand name furniture. Don't miss it. Nowhere in America would you get a selection like this. Mattresses by Landonade and Serta, chairs by Berkline, Stylecraft, Chief City, all of it on the block. All of it being discounted and discounted drastically 7 days a week. Everything in this store is on the block, but hurry. When it's gone, it's gone. Valley Furniture is going out of business.
Run this offense really good now, huh? One, two, three.
Let's go.
Let's go. Get the ball inbound safe. Get it inbound safe.
How many timeouts we have left? Tony.
There you get a good idea. What is it like to be in a pressure huddle? And the pressure will continue before this thing is over. He made an interesting point. He said, keep your rear ends down and your hands up on defense. Damon Dragotis. De La Salle with the ball. 5-point lead. They're telling Cotter, come on up. What they're trying to do, I guess from what I got from the huddle, is pull the defense out and then come in the back door. I don't think they had quite that in mind. Here is a foul. Dragotis was hammered by Jeff Glowacki. One of the few fouls in the game.
They lost Dragotis inside. Well, actually, he got lucky. There was a ball that was tipped by the Cotter player, and Dragotis happened to be in the right place at the right time.
And this will be the first free throw of the day for De La Salle.
But look who's shooting it, Ray.
No fouls now.
Damon the Dragon. Got it. I love those haircuts. Coach told him, come to this tournament, with your hair cut short and dressed like you're going on a job interview. And the players took him one step further by getting those 1950s style haircuts.
Must be a job at a malt shop.
Ailey all alone. He's got the little set shot and he flicked it and it popped in. 42-37, 5-point lead De La Salle, 5:15 remaining in regulation. Baker. And on top to Dragotis. Baker. He can move around pretty well. He doesn't score many points. Wynn being guarded by Hailey. Hailey almost got it. Head fake. Rolls out of there. And Glowacki has the rebound for Winona Cotter. They can cut the lead to 3. 4:35 left. 42-37 De La Salle for the Class A championship. Lead pass intended for Glowacki. And Baker. Now stolen, Hailey. Wynn knocks it out of bounds. Wynn saved 2 points with that play.
Heads up play by Hailey. Anticipation by Hailey. Cut right in front of the man. Good defensive play to save 2 points, though.
42-37, De La Salle. Cotter with the ball. That's Hailey on top. Galkowski. He's a good shot. Inside to Glowacki, cutting. Good athletic play by Glowacki just to hold on to that thing. Shot no good up there by Drussel. Dragotis. 42-37, 3:55 left. De La Salle with the lead. Dragotis. Yes. He strikes again.
He lulled the man guarding the sweep.
He has 20. Good defensive play, McLaughlin, but he couldn't hold on to it out of bounds. Cotter will inbound. And a timeout on the floor with a score. De La Salle 44, Winona Cotter 37.
Calcium and protein too helps us feel good in whatever we do.
Kick.
So get on a health kick, let it pour. America's favorite health kick. Get on a health kick, milk's got more. Have more milk, 'cause milk's got more.
Spring's on the way. That means it's time to plan for the growing season. R&D Spray in Grand Meadow is one of Minnesota's largest spray equipment dealers. They carry top brand equipment like Walsh's Time Ride and Top Air's Tandem Axle Sprayers, plus Monarch Fertilizer Pumps and P&H Anhydrous Ammonia equipment. R&D has served a farmer for more than 7 years, and they put that experience to work for you in their six-day-a-week service. At R&D Spray, they say, when the farmer works, we work. In Grand Meadow, daily UPS service too.
Mike O'Brien, as they were breaking up that huddle, said, we have to do it on defense. We have to shut them down. Get the ball.
They need this basket badly.
Cotter inbounding. That is Galkowski.
No!
Jump ball. As we look at it again, a little bit of football going on there.
Tough to see whether it was a true jump ball or not, but the referee called it, so it's a jump ball.
McLaughlin and Glowacki. That's Dragotis. And here's a foul.
Mike David, hold that ball tight, triple threat. Line.
Trying to figure out who got that foul. It was Glowacki, and that was his second foul. They're having to foul now. 3:12 remaining. De La Salle up by 7 points, 44-37. Damon Dragotis.
Look for it!
In no hurry to fire anything up there, unless if it's a shot like that, where you can either draw a foul or can it. And here's a foul on Cotter.
He'll give, well, it didn't start out late enough, but he gave the kid about two or three rocker steps and then just blew by him. His first step is just very quick.
Foul on Galkowski, his first.
Look at the graphic, 12 for 14 from the line. That's excellent shooting from the free throw.
And the Dragon cans it, and he now has 21 points. Of fine players will come into this tournament and be intimidated by the size of the building and television and the crowds, but it has not bothered Damon Dragotis. 46-37. De La Salle, High Lee with that set shot, got it. 2:43 left. There you see the score. 7-point lead for De La Salle. It around that perimeter in no hurry to get anything going because they want the clock now as an ally. 2:15 left. Baker being guarded by Malley. Hey, they're in no hurry, they just bring it back out again. 2 minutes. 2 minutes left. McLaughlin almost lost it. Almost lost it again. Wynn. Got it. Oh,
what a basket. What a basket.
He wanted that one. 48-39, De La Salle.
A little bit of luck involved in this last basket, but you got to have luck, too. Good pass by McLaughlin. Wynn, a little off balance, throws it up. It goes down. He'll take it, believe me.
Full court. Now, the guy we want to foul, if he's the guy you're guarding, or the guy you're guarding, or the guy you're guarding. Any of those three. As soon as they get the ball, go after it hard. Go after it hard, okay? On the rebound, again, we got to break it down court as quick as we can and get the shot off of the rebound, okay?
Help out on doubling it.
They're down nine. They've got to really put the ball up. Cut them off. Don't foul anybody, all right? Think. If you get...
How bad you want it, Lyle?
Yeah. One, two, three.
Don't get it. Hang on the ball yourself.
I think we have to wait till we get a 4-point turnaround. Take it. You can't take it. Train. We got to take it.
All right, the battle of the field generals now are the guys who are not on the front lines, but the generals with the long, heavy, thick eyeglasses calling out the strategy, the coaches. They needed that. Dragotis into the front court. A minute 30 left. De La Salle may be on their way to their state championship. What a pass.
What a pass.
And a shot. Oh. Pass of the game. And the bucket goes to Moser.
We can get that, it'd be worth seeing.
The Dragon has more than one other way to bite you.
Go in.
Good shot by Dressel. 50-41, De La Salle. We have 1:04 left.
One, three, hey, they intentionally go. They're intentionally fouling. Hey, you did a good job. Nice job.
Fans at home will get a chance to see Dragotis' last pass. Oh, he has quick hands. He's going to make a penetrating move real soon. There he goes. Now watch this. Saw him out of the corner of his eye.
Oh, shades of Larry Bird.
Yep.
Dragotis.
And I don't think that was one of the guys that Coach O'Brien wanted fouled.
20, 3 points for Dragotis. Well, the screen said 22. We had 23.
Now he has 23.
Now he has 20. We say he has 24. What the heck? We'll figure it out. 1 point. On the drive. Boy, don't you love the way Glowacki plays. 52 seconds left. 52 to 43, De La Salle. And here is a foul. Is going to be called on Galkowski of Winona Cotter.
Do you think that anywhere today so far we have seen candidates for Mr. Basketball, gentlemen?
Hey, Mike!
We have some candidates I know in the tournament, and I know we're going to see some tonight.
Well, Godas has got to be in the running.
Hey! I salute Coach Mike O'Brien of Winona Cotter. There you see the attendance. You know what he just told a couple of the kids on the bench who were starting to act up? He walked over to his own players in the heat of this game, and he said, behave yourselves. There's a foul. 40 seconds left in De La Salle by 9, 52 to 43.
There is no way at this time that Coach Zierden wants any of his players to foul anybody. The clock stops. Now if he makes both ends, they steal the ball again. That's 4 points with maybe 3 seconds running off the clock.
De La Salle has been in this tournament in 1975 and 83. And the free throw is good by Galkowski. Coach Zierden was on the De La Salle team as a player when they came here in 75.
Got to be a winner.
In and out. 52-48, 8-point lead. Cotter with it. 36 seconds left. And they needed that. Look at that pass by the Dragon. Doesn't lead to a basket, but that's him coming down and getting the ball. Look at that pass! Basket! McLaughlin.
Don't foul him, son. Let him shoot.
Cotter still scrambling. Look at that. They are not giving up. 10 seconds left.
We did it. All of you. Stay back. Stay back. Stay back.
Look at Zierden.
Stay back. We did it.
They know the victory is theirs. 10 seconds left, and they lead by 10. Dragotis whips a pass to McLaughlin. Look out. Kwame McDonald almost got hammered under that basket down there. Kwame picking up the gallant Jeff Glowacki.
Danny Dunn starts singing Turn Out the Light.
I'll tell you, a magic moment in the lives of these De La Salle players, and our hearts go out to Winona Cotter. They finished second last year to Pelican Rapids.
Not a bad place to be, second in the state, but
Cotter won this championship in 1977 and 82 under John Nett.
We're going in. You four, check in.
Substitutions are coming in here in wholesale quantities now. With 6 seconds left.
It's been a long, tough season, and you know, this is very important to you. You might not think it's important to you right now, but you know, with the eyes of Minnesota on you, it will be very important to you in the future. Okay? Let's play hard in this last 6 seconds, get the rebound and get it down court, and get a good shot.
Well,
that's important. Okay? And when you get back, let's get our warm-up jackets.
Come on.
Win a victory.
Mike O'Brien quietly conceding defeat over there, but telling his team, you finish this game out with honor, with your heads high.
Most important thing he could have told his players.
There are no losers here today. I know that they may feel that they have lost this game at Winona Cotter, but for a coach like that taking on the grand tradition of John Nett, and maybe coming up behind a great De La Salle team in points. But I think in the eyes of Minnesota, we're just proud to be in the same building with both of these squads. 56-44, 6 seconds left. The season is counting down for Class A. Driving. Lawecki. He's not giving up. And it's all over. The championship trophy for the first time ever will go to Minneapolis De La Salle. Congratulations to our 11th, 8th ranked team. They are the champions. And that is the end of the game. The final score. Minneapolis De La Salle 56. Winona Cotter 46.
Guide for U.S. citizens living abroad? These papers legal?
Along with many other helpful publications, free from the IRS.
Tax information for homeowners, child care?
Here's one on moving expenses.
We're moving?
Say it again, Sam.
We're moving!
Your IRS tax package has a list of the more popular subjects and an order form.
All right, they're getting ready for the presentation of the medals and the trophies.
Second place team.
Julie Pearl.
Trophies are presented to the championship team, the second place team, third place team, and the winner of the consolation championship. Silver medals and a Class A trophy. The second place will be awarded to Winona Cotter. First, Tony Spelt. Mark Thine. Hi Lee. Matt Molly. Jeff Glowacki.
You know, Dan, while we're watching the players come over and get their medals, thinking about Coach O'Brien and what he told those kids.
Jamie Gustavski.
You hold your heads high. You finish this thing with honor, and it brings back a memory to me that's long gone, but I remember it. I remember one time I threw a bat in a baseball game, a high school baseball game, and I took three steps, and my huge coach, Clyde Ficklin, hit his hand right on my neck. And he said to me, and he said something nice first. He said, "You're one of our best players.
Jeff Hunt.
But don't ever do that again or you'll never be on this team." And I never did it again.
Steve Mojeski.
The point that he made was, it might not seem big today, but it will years from now. And that's important. These kids will never, ever forget the state tournament. And if they had a bad memory because they acted like jerks after a loss, they would remember that till the day they died.
John Wineski, student manager. Now the captains can come forward and get the second place trophy.
We applaud them. They have won this championship twice, and in the last 2 years, they take home the second place trophy. To Winona Cotter. Last year they lost to Pelican Rapids and of course losing just moments ago to this great De La Salle squad.
Tournament. The schools of Minnesota have been actively involved in the promotion of good sportsmanship this past winter season. The evaluation committee has selected Glenwood for the sportsmanship trophy. Will the captains come forward and get a trophy? Glenwood High School. answer. Len Boylan. Scott Cop. Isabel Apera. Tony Wojak. Doug Kilgan. Andy Longan. Harry Kaiser. Greg Moser. Sean Ogren. Tom McLaughlin. Jeff Johnson as student manager. Twenty-four. I didn't have him on the list. Evan Kennedy, you weren't on the list. Four is Nathan Carson, starter. Now you may get go forward and get the championship trophy.
You go show it to our fans, man.
Zirden says, show it to our fans all around the state of Minnesota. Two thoroughbreds battling it out for this championship, and guess what, gang? We've got two more games coming up between four outstanding teams tonight at 7 o'clock. Bloomington, Jefferson, and Duluth Central for third place in AA, and the dream matchup of the year, Minneapolis North and White Bear Lake. That's going to be an end. Okay, Zirden, Don Zirden coming over now. And I think he's with Randy.
Yep.
Let's go down to Randy.
All right, thanks very much, Tom. We're getting set up here to talk to Don Zirden and company. De La Salle heading this way. Coach, congratulations to you. What a way to close out your first season.
Thank you very much. It's the great kids that we have. That's the reason we're so successful, and I just like to say publicly that I love each and every one of them.
It was a great ball game. I thought in the second half you got the tempo going. You got the what you wanted to get done. The defense seemed to come through for you, and you got a couple of breaks along the way.
You know, the kids all week and all year have followed what we wanted to do. And we knew that if we kept the pressure on, it would pay off for us, because we didn't think they had found a team that pressured them that much. And we wanted to run an offense where we posted people up, and that's what we did.
You were in foul trouble early, but you stayed out of foul trouble in the second half, and you were able to do the things you needed to do.
I think a lot of that is tribute to the kids, their intelligence and their conditioning. You know, they looked like they weren't reaching, and they were in good shape in the second half.
Well, everybody upstairs is impressed with the entire team as a team, but there's a guy that stands out at guard, named Damon Dragotis, that had another great ball game, and he really has done it for you all year long.
Damon's our leader. He makes everyone else look that much better. And it's just a thrill to have him. I'm going to miss him and very much, as well as all the other seniors.
Well, let's talk to Damon Dragotis. Damon, step up here.
Go get it, Damon.
Congratulations to you. This is a big game. At the end of the first half, what did your coach say to you to get you guys get going in the second half, because you turned things around for you?
Well, he just told us to relax. That's what we were a little tense out there, and just to play our game and play tough defense, and that's what we did in the second half, and it worked. So.
What does it feel like to be a state champion?
It's great. We worked all season long. This is our goal, and we did it. So.
Everybody upstairs has been commenting on your haircuts all game. Was it worth it?
Yeah.
They say, everybody says it was their choice that they got the haircut. Well, congratulations to all of you. De La Salle, the Class A champions. Let's go back upstairs.
Okay, Randy, thank you very much. Very good. The champions from De La Salle now in the ritual of cutting down the net, and it will be in their trophy case forever. Well, I tell you, the Dragon and company, they were just downright impressive, I think, over a fine Winona Cotter team.
I don't know whether this is a fair statement or not, an assessment or evaluation, but don't the kids get younger every year? And so much more talented.
Yes.
Oh, gosh. Gosh.
Dan, the game, while they're cutting down that net, let's talk about the game tonight momentarily because we have a second to do it. The dream matchup is here. Minneapolis North, White Bear Lake, they're both 25-0. Minneapolis North's record is 25-0-1. They tied with your St. Paul Central team when the humidity caused the floor to become too slippery to play, so they just stopped playing. But I don't know of anybody any more qualified to give a thought on this game tonight than you.
Minneapolis North felt they won the game last year and then gave it away. They felt they had it in the palm of their hand. White Bear Lake never quit. They did nothing but come back and take the game. Both teams did nothing, I'm sure, but in the locker room talk about coming back next year and playing again. We thought, St. Paul Central thought, we were going to have something to say about whether North got there or not. We obviously did not. Now that talk that was done a year ago, today or whatever, is back where it belongs, and we'll see who is number one. They have been 1-2 all year long in your ratings, the AP poll also. It'll be decided tonight.
So, Ray, it's time for the talking to stop and the action to begin.
You know one thing, if I may go back to the game that just completed, if we could have one play etched in stone, would be that beautiful pass of Dragotis to his teammate. And when it meant something, the game was not decided yet because I admire the skills of these young men, and they just keep getting better and better and better. What a game. And more tonight.
All right, two more games left, as Ray says, and we're going to get some coffee and a sandwich. We hope you do the same and be ready to come back and join us at 7 o'clock tonight as we'll have the third-place game between two veteran coaches, Duluth Central's Jim Hastings and Jack Evans of Bloomington Jefferson, and, of course,